Use these free ChatGPT tips to save you even more time in your day. Hey techies, I'm Tasia Custodian. Welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share a ton of tech tips just like this. Here are five ChatGPT tips to save you time. First, specify a role. Who do you want ChatGPT to be, and what is this persona good at? So think, if you could talk to an expert in any field, pretend that's ChatGPT and assign it that role. Think things like you're a nutritionist, maybe you're an accountant with 20 years experience, or even you're a classically trained actor. You're a rocket scientist with a PhD in astrophysics. You get the idea here. Better yet, you can reverse engineer this or add to this prompt, if you will, by giving yourself a role, or more specifically, specifying the audience. Here's what I mean. So we gave ChatGPT a role of a nutritionist with a focus on longevity health. So we're narrowing down that role a little bit here. Now let's give myself a role, or specify the audience, if you will. So maybe our prompt is write a weekly meal plan for a 40-year-old healthy female who is lactose intolerant, eats mostly plant-based, and is looking to increase her protein intake. Bang, suddenly you've got a much more structured reply in far less time because you've really honed in on what it is you want. You've defined a role and you've specified the audience. This is gonna help you get the answer you want a lot faster without so much back and forth of constantly re-prompting and refining the results. And if you want to learn any more tips on prompt engineering, I've got a video on that linked for you in the description below, where I actually go over Google's 5-part prompt formula that's really going to help you get more out of your LLM, no matter which one you're using. You'll get closer to what you want in less time. The second ChatGPT tip to save you time is to jump into the personalization features to create custom instructions. This is a classic example of spending a few minutes up front can save you a ton of time later. From ChatGPT, click on your profile icon and then click on personalization. First, make sure the option to enable customization is toggled on too, because this is going to give you a really fun way where you can customize how ChatGPT responds to you. So here you could give yourself a nickname. This is going to be what ChatGPT will call you from here on out. You can add in your occupation, so it's going to know how to tailor responses better to you specifically. And you can add other information like interests or preferences you'd like ChatGPT to keep in mind. You can also adjust the base style and tone here. Now, this is going to save you time if you only want responses specific to a certain tone, like maybe it's straight to the point or something more sarcastic is your jam. This way, you don't have to ask for that tone every single time you prompt. But here, under custom instructions, you can add additional behavior, style, and tone preferences. So think, like, do you want ChatGPT to remain neutral, or maybe you want it to have an opinion? How long of responses do you want? Are there examples of a style that you'd like ChatGPT to behave like? Anything like this can go in here. The thing to keep in mind here in your personalization preferences is to not give away any confidential or sensitive information, obviously, but this is all to help you tailor those responses so you don't have to keep doing it time and time again when you're prompting. A bit of work on the front end saves you a ton of time on the back end. All right, tip number three is to use custom GPTs. Now, custom GPTs are custom versions of ChatGPT that you can tailor for specific tasks or topics that combine knowledge, information, and capabilities. Now, as this video focuses on completely free tips, it's important to note here that you can use custom GPTs as a free user. You can't create your own. Here's what this looks like. You're gonna head to ChatGPT's custom GPT store at chatgpt.com/GPTs. GPTs. Here, you can search for and explore all kinds of GPTs. So let's say you need a little help making a presentation, click on that GPT, and then click Start Chat. Here at the top, you're going to see you're utilizing this custom GPT. And by the way, here you can also click to pin this to your sidebar. This way, your presentation helper is always there for you, ready to go. So you don't always have to go to chatgpt.com/GPTs. A tailored GPT ready to help right here in ChatGPT. By the way, once you've pinned a GPT to your sidebar, you should also have a little GPT section with an option to explore. If you click on explore, that's going to pop you right back into that GPT's page where you can use even more custom GPTs. Pretty neat. ChatGPT hack number 4 is to organize and rename chat. All right, this may sound basic, but I am telling you right now, it's a huge time saver because it's going to keep you way more productive and way more organized. All you need to do is hover over a chat in the sidebar, click the 3-dot menu icon, and click rename chat. This is going to help you make sense of all your chats at one glance, as opposed to a random title that ChatGPT gives it. And don't be afraid to click that 3-dot menu icon and either archive or delete a chat. Now, if you delete it, it's gone. Whereas if you archive a chat, it clears it from your sidebar, so it gets rid of that clutter, but you can head to your settings, data controls, and manage your archived chats from here. So if you made a mistake and you want to unarchive it, you could do so. Or if you'd rather just delete it instead, you can also do that from here in your settings. All of this to say, it helps clear that clutter from your chat history and it makes things easier and quicker to find. And the fifth ChatGPT tip to save you time is to connect apps. This is going to allow you to have an interactive experience with third-party apps right inside ChatGPT. We're gonna click our profile icon and we're gonna head to our settings again. Now here, click on apps and connectors. From here, you should have a few different apps like Booking.com, Canva, Spotify, and more that you can click on to connect to ChatGPT. You're just gonna click connect and it's going to be added for you. You're gonna know that an app is added because you can see it in this apps and connectors section. And then of course, you could also click on it to disconnect it from here anytime too. Alternatively, to connect or ask an app something directly in ChatGPT, right in the prompt bar, you could type in the at symbol and then the app name. So as an example, at Spotify, make a playlist for my birthday party this Friday. Or you could say at Zillow, show me Paradise Valley listings under $3 million. Hey, a girl can dream. But seriously, instead of having to go to that third-party app, now you can get done what you need, when you need it, right inside ChatGPT. No muss, no fuss. So those are my top 5 ChatGPT tips to save you time. And now I want to hear from you. What are you doing inside ChatGPT to save you even more time in your day? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or you can leave that comment below. You can also click right about here to subscribe to my channel and here for even more LLM goodness. Thanks for watching. See you next time.